Heart disease is one of the leading killers not only in the UK, but in most developed countries. Chances are that someone in your family was advised by their doctor to change their diet.
Have you ever wondered what scientists we have to thank for the existence of such advice?
One of them is the American biochemist Marie Maynard Daly, who was the first African-American woman in the United States to earn a PhD in chemistry, which was awarded by Columbia University in 1947.
Daly and her colleagues did some of the earliest work on the relationship between diet and heart disease. They investigated the impact of cholesterol, sugar, and other nutrients. She was the first to establish that high blood pressure is a precursor to atherosclerosis, which is a disease in which the inside of an artery narrows due to the buildup of plaque. She found a link between high cholesterol intake in diet and clogged arteries, a link which stirs up a lot of debate even to this day. Daly was particularly interested in nuclear proteins. She developed methods for the fractionation of nuclear material and the determination of its composition. She studied histones, which are proteins found in cell nuclei, and her work in this area is now considered to be fundamental. In 1953, James Watson and Francis Crick determined the structure of DNA. Accepting the Nobel Prize for this work in 1962, Watson cites one of Daly's papers as contributing to his work. If you ever heard of bodybuilders, you probably know that they're renowned for taking supplements to enhance their performance. Well, one very popular supplement that they use is creatine. In the 1970s, Daly began studying this compound, and she wrote a paper that described the conditions under which muscle tissues best absorbed creatine. Daly was inspired by her father, who attended Cornell but wasn't able to finish due to a lack of funds. Many years later, she started the Queen's College Scholarship Fund in his honor to assist minority students majoring in chemistry or physics. We all have something to learn from such a great scientist.